What do you mean by mass media? When you are communicating a message through a technology to a large discrete number of people, then that becomes mass media. Anyone can say, here I'm also using a microphone and speaking to a large number of people like you. But the logic and the basic definition of this such is that you, when you are congregating here, maybe here 50 students you are congregated, that would be a, as she said about Ramlila Maidan, where Anna Hazare is addressing maybe 50,000 people. But even that 50,000 people, one person addressing 50,000 people will not fit into the classical definition of mass media. Because that classical definition suggests that you need to use technology to disseminate information to a large number of people who are not correlated to each other. But when 50 students have congregated here, you are correlated. You may not personally know each other, but you correlate each other and you have come for a basic purpose. And the same is true in a larger scale in a crowd at Ramlila Maidan. So only when a technology is used to generate information and send it across time and space to a large number of people who do not have any correlation with each other. Who could be that kind of persons? Readers of a newspaper. You may read a newspaper sitting at Gym C. Someone is reading a newspaper sitting at Sector 15. Someone else is reading in Sarita Bihar, another person in Lakshmi Nagar, and some other person in Ahmedabad, someone in Bhopal, someone in Bellary, or someone maybe in Washington DC. And all these people are not correlated to each other, but they are reading the same newspaper. Same is the truth about television. You may sit anywhere. If you are looking at an international television channel, BBC for example, you sitting cozy in Sector 47 in the JPS hostel, maybe watching television, and there would be someone looking at the same BBC television somewhere in Adelaide or Melbourne or Sussex, or if you say somewhere inside in the hinterland of UP or Bihar or Orissa. So that's what constitutes the elements of mass media: print, newspaper, television, radio, cinema. Look at the reach of cinema. The cinema, everywhere, the Hindi cinema, for example, you people see in the West Asia, in Americas, in Europe, in Australia, in all parts of India and South Asia, everywhere. So it's a communication. All those who look at a movie, they do not necessarily share any kind of relationship with each other. They are too discreet to have any shared relationship. But they only share that one common relationship, that is, they are the active consumers of that mass medium. So it could be print, it could be television, it could be radio, it could be movies, it could be books. The books that you read, any book If you remember a small, the book Amitav Ghosh wrote, it will be read across the world, in the tiniest town or village in India to the largest of the cities of the world. Everyone who has a desire to read, desire to imbibe certain new ideas, would like to love a book which is written by an author who is celebrated worldwide. So this is what constitutes the mass media. Why is mass media or media so important? Today, if you look at it, in the entire world, the mass media have emerged the most powerful, potent instrument of public opinion. What they call the mass media as the storyteller, as the creator of entire cultural design. What is a country's culture today is being determined by years and decades of the messages transmitted by the mass media. Its importance is often reflected in that classic statement by a famous scholar of mass media. In fact, someone would give these mediums the name, the media, mass media, a professor called Marshall McLuhan. He asked a very, very simple question. The fish, when it is wet, does it know the existence of water? It's a big hypothetical question he posed to the world. And he answered, no. Why? Because water so dominates the life of the fish that it does not realize its importance until it is taken out of the water. Only when a fish is taken out of the water, then only it realizes, oh, there is something called water which gives me the lifeline. And McLuhan said, this is exactly true about the mass media and the human beings. Thank you.